As opposed to some of the more motion and other things that you've done
technically? It's pretty tough, but you have to trust your game plan, trust your teammates, trust everything that it took to get to this point, and continue to stay ready, continue to do the things that got us to this point.
Is it, you go against the ultimate move and optimal team, and you do that now? Hardly ever move it out.
Yeah.
Is that just, you got to be new kind of thing?
Man, you know what? There's more than one way to win, and I guess this season kind of proved for us that it's more than one way to win, so what we've been doing has been working, and we just got to continue to play hard, continue to do the things that we do well, and continue to do the things that we do well defensively.
Are you going to change valuable as a
player? I think it's extremely valuable. It's a place that you're comfortable with, play the majority of your games there, and your home crowd, your home fans are screaming pretty loud at the other team, so it's huge, it's a huge advantage, and we're looking forward to it.
In that sense,
do you
think it'll be more of an advantage?
Well, that's a good team. I don't think playing against them home or away makes a difference. They're going to play the same way. So for us, it's about just continue to push, continue to grind, take it one play at a time. You mess up the play before, forget about it and move on. But staying locked in is the most important thing for us.
Have you guys been good at those two things, staying locked in and forgetting before plays?
I think we've done a pretty good job all year of moving on to the next play. It's hard to stay extremely focused for 48 minutes in a basketball game. Something's going to happen, stop play. But against a team like the Warriors, you can't afford to have mental lapses back to back to back. You always got to stay ready.
How confident are you about
defensively, especially as you really face? I'm extremely confident about what we just did, whoever's on the court. We have a lot of guys with tremendous athleticism, can guard the ball, can do guard multiple positions, and we continue to get better. The deeper we get into the playoffs, the more we play, our confidence continues to build.
Is there any one certain way to slow Kevin Durant?
There's no one way to slow anybody who has the ball like that in their hands, or that tall, or that skilled. Anyway, so it's about just trying to make it tough as possible. Try to make it as comfortable as possible. Whatever you have to do to get a stop, that's what you have to do.
How much of it is the work you do before you get to it? Do you have to get the work done early with a guy who can shoot over
them? Yeah, I think you definitely have to get your work done early. Not let him get to his exact spots. Not let him move around the court the way he wants to move. I think that's the most important thing. Just try to make it as uncomfortable as possible.
Trevor, when they get rolling and they hit shots from mid 20 feet, whatever that is, does that kind of change the way where you have to be aware of someone farther away from the basket as a scoring threat? Like, at what point does someone become a scoring threat in this
game? Well, there's scoring threat from the other end of the court, especially how they get out and run the break. So you have to, as soon as the ball goes through the basket or the ball, or when they get the rebound, you got to be ready to guard from that point on. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.